Matthew Hatton. Matthew Hatton was sort of, he was definitely a natural welterweight, but he was not like an athletic specimen at all. Rhodes is athletic, and I think Alvarez realizes that, and that's why he trained here in the U.S., that's why he trained in Southern California, up in Big Bear Mountain. He wanted to get in hard work. He wanted to be 100% focused for this guy. And he definitely put the work in with the sparring because the guy, his main sparring partner, Gennady Golovkin, is a monster.
Yeah.
Just a real badass, 20-0, 17 knockouts from Kazakhstan. He's the WBA's regular title holder. And the dude, he's not well known, but he's a badass. And they were, you know, they didn't try to kill each other, but they worked hard. You know, 4-minute rounds at that
altitude.
Did you go
see them?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
I watched a sparring session.
Would you pay for such a sparring session, though?
Yeah, it was worth it. It was better than a lot of fights I've seen on premium cable. You know what I mean?
And you drove 4.5 hours to see it, so it would have been.
It was worth it. I didn't regret driving up the mountain, and I hate that drive.
And who won those rounds? The 20-year-old or the stupid star?
I'd have to give it to the bigger man. I'd have to give it to Golovkin because he actually rocked Alvarez in the second round. But Alvarez took it. It was a left hook. And you can see Alvarez's leg, you know, stiffen up, his right leg stiffen up.
Yeah.
But you know what? He just kind of walked it off in between the second and third rounds, and he got right back in there. And
he's a tough
he
dude.
He handled the pressure well because Golovkin knows how to cut the ring off, and he applies smart pressure. But
so,
and Alvarez, you know, he didn't just try to survive, you know. He stuck and moved, and he landed. He gave as good as he got.
What's your prediction for Rhodes against Alvarez?
I like Alvarez by decision. You know, maybe if he commits to the body well, he can get a late stoppage. But I think Ryan Rhodes is a tougher opponent than Matthew Hatton. There's no doubt about that.
There you have it, boxing expert of RingTV.com, Doug Fisher, BSMovieReporting.com, and Melissa Back Reporting.